After a slight delay, CEO Elon Musk says that SpaceX is now on track to stack a complete Starship prototype on top of a Super Heavy booster, for the first time ever as early as Friday morning. In the latest stage of SpaceX's continually impressive Starbase Surge, the company rolled the first orbital-class Starship prototypes, aft tank section from its birthplace in the factory, midbay, to a much larger high bay, around noon on August 3rd. Mere hours later, Elon Musk revealed that SpaceX had fitted the Starship with a full 6 Raptors, a first for any Starship prototype, though Super Heavy Booster 4 technically beat it to the punch, with the installation of a staggering 29 Raptor engines hours prior. The rocket's conical nose section joined it in the high bay later that evening, and SpaceX wasted no time stacking and welding the two Starship halves together, early on August 4th, effectively completing the basic structure of Ship 20. After a day of final integration work, Starship S20 left the high bay around dawn on August 5th, and took to the highway for a brief trip from SpaceX's Boca Chica factory to launch and testing facilities just a mile and a half to the east. On August 3rd, Super Heavy Booster 4 fitted with 29 functional Raptor engines, made the same trip from build site to launch pad, where it sat on the transporter overnight. On August 4th, with slightly calmer winds, SpaceX installed the immense approximately 69 meters, approximately 225 feet tall rocket booster on an orbital launch mount, that itself had only been installed less than a week prior. Together, Ship 20 and Booster 4 represent both stages of the integrated vehicle that will support Starship's first orbital test flight. A mission that's expected to occur before the end of the year. In the interim, a great deal of work remains, but SpaceX is far closer than it's ever been, with both an orbital-class Starship and Super Heavy nearly complete. Of course, both those rocket stages have plenty of crucial steps to check off before SpaceX can truly consider them ready for flight. Like all Starship prototypes, Ship 20 will need to complete proof testing after assembly is complete. Notably, Ship 20 is the first Starship prototype with mounting points for a full 6 Raptors, meaning that it will almost certainly be put through an even more rigorous proof test, in which hydraulic rams will simulate the thrust of those engines. In fact, one of SpaceX's two suborbital launch mounts has already been fitted with a 3-ram jig, used to test several earlier prototypes and, more importantly, modified with 3 rams to simulate 3 Raptor vacuum engines. The engines installed on Ship 20 on August 3rd are likely just a fit test or practice for the real deal, and will need to be uninstalled for said hydraulic ram cryo proof in the near future. The same might be true for Super Heavy Booster 4, which had 29 Raptor engines installed in 14 hours, in a spectacular and unprecedented feat of rocket assembly. At least 5 of its engines appear to have never been static fired, implying that those engines, at minimum, will likely be removed and sent back to SpaceX's McGregor development facilities for individual qualification testing before being declared ready for flight. Ultimately, regardless of when they may or may not be ready to be fired, stacked into a fully integrated Starship rocket, or even launched, the vast majority of orbital test flight hardware is complete or already at the launch pad. Local Boca Chica photographers have been documenting SpaceX's daily progress at Starbase. In some of their images, you can see the enormous scale of Booster 4, as well as the dimensions of the Raptor engines in comparison to a human. Sea-level Raptor engines have a diameter of around 4 feet and a height of 9 feet. Unlike the company's other rockets, which are powered by kerosene and liquid oxygen, Raptors are a full-flow, staged combustion engine, powered by a combination of cryogenic methane and cryogenic liquid oxygen, which is a true innovation in the aerospace industry. Other rocket engines were designed for no, or almost no reuse, Musk said last year. Raptor is designed for heavy and immediate reuse, like an aircraft jet engine, with inspections required only after many flights, assuming instrumentation shows it good. Ship 20 arrived at the orbital launch site a few hours after heading out and was eventually moved directly beside Booster 4, and the orbital launch mount and attached to the largest crane in SpaceX's arsenal. After several hours sitting in one place, SpaceX announced over a site-wide loudspeaker system that all further stacking operations had been called off for the day, which Musk later confirmed on Twitter was due to wind conditions at the launch site. Had the weather cooperated, SpaceX's plan was to install Starship S20 on top of Super Heavy Booster 4, a feat that would have marked the first time a two-stage Starship rocket has ever been fully assembled. Due to the current setup's temporary nature, SpaceX must complete that stacking process with a vast crawler crane, the same crane used to fully assemble approximately 145 meters, approximately 475 feet tall Starship Integration Tower, visible directly behind the rocket. Sitting on top of the fairly tall orbital launch mount, Starship S20 and Super Heavy Booster 4 will stand about as tall as that 145 meters launch tower. Though the booster and ship itself are expected to be just shy of 120 meters, approximately 390 feet, from tip to Raptor tail. Once stacked, the vehicle will be the tallest rocket assembled in the history of spaceflight. Their current plan is to launch Super Heavy from South Texas and land it in the Gulf of Mexico, soon after dropping off Starship SN20 to orbit. SN20 will fly in space above the Florida Straits, then re-enter Earth's atmosphere, to splash down off the coast of Hawaii. The flight will provide engineers with valuable data, to develop the spacecraft and improve concept of operations. A specific launch date is still not publicly established, because SpaceX is still pending necessary regulatory approvals from the Federal Aviation Administration, to proceed with this launch. SpaceX currently runs 24/7 shifts to prepare the launch vehicle, for this ambitious orbital test. The company is making progress at an unprecedented speed for the past couple of weeks. The vehicle looks very cool with hundreds of hexagonal heat tiles, that will protect it from the extremely high temperatures it will experience as it re-enters Earth's rough atmosphere. On August 3 at midnight, Musk shared they finished installing 6 Raptor engines, to the first orbital Starship. It will be the first test vehicle to be equipped with 3 vacuum-optimized Raptors RVAC, with a much larger bell nozzle for propulsion in space. The Raptor engine is special, designed to give astronauts the option to return to Earth from Mars. Through the Sabatier process and electrolysis, future Mars settlers could synthesize methalox propellant for Starship by using resources already on the Martian surface, which include water, ice, and carbon dioxide in the planet's atmosphere. This design choice shows that SpaceX is very serious about making life multiplanetary. Musk hopes the first sustainable Mars colony could be established before the year 2050. The company plans to manufacture a fleet of 1,000 Starships over the course of 20 years to make it possible. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.